Hey guys, what's up? It is Sunday night. Tomorrow's Christmas Eve. Just had dinner, just kind of hanging out, got some music going in one ear, and want to show you guys something interesting, something that's obviously out of the norm. We're going to be taking a look at the, well, it's from Sergey Rogovets, a custom knife maker who I have featured on my channel numerous times, because I certainly respect his work. Second generation jewelry maker. His fit and finish and his precision is truly quite remarkable, considering that he uses no CNC technology. Again, I don't care if people use CNC, the end result is really what matters for me. But, you know, you have to give it to them when they can do things by hand that other people certainly cannot. So, Sergey makes a lot of different things. You know, his background as a jewelry maker, I mean, he made me this really cool pen. Brass copper, this thing's heavy as hell, but a nice bolt action. Sergey, if you can, make some of these in titanium. Might be a little bit more carryable. Although, you know, again, I'm an addict or an enthusiast, so I'll carry heavy crap I shouldn't. Modded a really cool Zippo. He's done leather work. I haven't really used this one yet, but it matches my knife, which, you know, is something that we do. And this is the Model 17. This is the one that I commissioned from him and he built for me specifically, including the graphics, which again, you know, it's a love it or hate it thing, whatever. I like it. I couldn't care less. So let's move all that out of the way. Oh, I want to show you guys one other thing that he made. His photography is truly quite impressive as well. So here's a nice little calendar he sent me. When he sent me this one to borrow, this is going to be going back to him. But his photography is incredible. He makes calendars. I don't know, he just kind of does it all. But let's take a look at the thing you guys are here for, which is the, I don't know if there's a model name or number, but it's a folding scythe. So, yeah, there's that. You know, again, this is obviously not a piece for everyone. This is a very unique piece. This is for the guy who already has, you know, 10 or 20 or 30, you know, perfect everyday carry knives. This is something completely out of the norm. So let me show you guys a couple of macros of this thing. And again, I know that 90% of you would never buy a folding scythe, but we'll call it 98% of you would never buy a folding scythe. But for the 2% who would, you know, here's something you could see. For those who wouldn't ever buy it, well, you know, again, it's fun to see it, which is really kind of the reason when he said, hey, I'd like to send you this, I was like, absolutely, I would love to see that, handle it, check it out. As soon as I got it in the mail, I wandered around the house looking for things to cut with it because I really wanted to try it. My wife was not as amused. So look at the beautiful work on the pivot there, both sides. Very, very cool. He makes his own custom pivots. Handles, again, everything's done by hand. Obviously, there's a wire wheel finish. And by hand, I mean obviously as, you know, certain machines, drill press, you know, belt grinder, things like that. The bamboo-looking backspacer here is hand-carved out of carbon fiber. Has a lanyard hole at the end. Carbon fiber pocket clip that, oddly enough, works well. I think it's due to the length. I've seen or had certain carbon fiber clips that do not work at all. This one works well, nicely sculpted, beautiful piece. Obviously ties in with the backspacer, lock bar cutout, flipper tab. And look at the travel on this thing. It is ridiculous. And this is one where you want to be careful when you're closing it. You don't really want your hand in the way when this thing folds down. So you can move it. But anyways, it's cool to see stuff like this and not necessarily have to buy it to enjoy it. You know, which is what shows do for a lot of people, is be able to see things that they perhaps don't know if they want to buy or wouldn't buy, but get to check out in person. He did sculpting on the stainless steel lock insert here. You know, it's not just a flat, you know, machined out lock insert part that's thrown in there. He actually did work on the hardened steel, which again is cool. Even his lock bar insert has been cut in such a way that it fits in the frame perfectly. You know, there aren't any large gaps or anything like that. So, a lot of really, really nice work. Again, I have the highest respect for his work. I think the one area that Sergey lacks is essentially creating knives that have more universal or mass appeal. Let me show you guys an example of what I'm talking about. And again, this one is coming as no surprise, but the Sebenza, a very clean, simple, straightforward design. It has mass appeal. There are any number of people who would happily, you know, buy or carry, and honestly, there are tons of people who do. What's in my pocket? The Shirogorov F95. Again, simple, clean design work, timeless, really. Another one that's more recent is the ZT640. Couldn't remember the model number. Again, simple, clean, timeless design. Another one is, of course, like the Para 2, which, although is a little less simple and clean, it still has a timeless appeal to it. So, you know, I would love to see Sergey bring something out that has a little more straightforward design. I want him to have a piece that has mass appeal so people are more willing to try and appreciate his work. He kind of, you know, marches to the beat of his own drum. He does a lot of really interesting pieces. Again, the Model 17 that I currently own is along the lines of one of his more reserved designs, a little more clean and straightforward and simple. But again, this one has a lot of laser work, which I love. Full Timascus backspacer that is impeccably finished. Very, very well finished. So anyways, you know, again, he only made a couple of these folding scythe things. It's just something fun that you would want to try if you had the opportunity at to get together or a show. So, I don't know. Just want to share that with you guys. Just kind of hanging out, chatting. Obviously, this is how it fits in my hand here. I mean, it cuts. It's a sharp object. Is this something you want to pull out of your kid's soccer game? Probably not. Is this something you'd want to pull out of a knife to get together to show other people? Absolutely. So, I don't know. It carries, honestly, fairly well. I mean, it's the overall width isn't too large throughout most of the knife. So I've carried in pocket. It's just been something fun and different for me. So, I mean, that's the whole premise of these things. It's different. It's interesting. So, again, I know that 98% of you would not buy something like this. So hopefully you enjoyed checking it out on this video today. Are there any more macro shots we need to get of it? Oh, look at the pivot. So well done. I think that's pretty much it. So anyways, be sure to check out Sergey's website and Instagram. Again, his photography is incredible. I like his work a lot. So we'll leave it there. And yeah, see you guys.